So what is space reservation? And now we're going up the abstraction layers, and we're actually talking about the LUN at the top there. And so space reservation on a LUN has two particular purposes. One is it designates space equal to the size of the LUN during LUN creation or at any time if you set that option. Again, we'll talk about changing that later on. So that's going to make sure that at least that LUN can exist. The second reason is to reserve space for overwrites, which is the reason why you often hear the fractional reserve volume option referred to as the overwrite reserve. We're going to go ahead and walk through a couple of examples. This is going to illustrate effectively how snapshots, writes, and LUNs and space reservations work in an ONTAP volume. First, we create a 50 gigabyte LUN in a 100 gigabyte volume with space reservation enabled. And this is 100% fractional reserve as well. We haven't really covered the fractional reserve topic, but we will shortly. And as you can see, there's space designated in the volume, but there isn't actually any data written to the volume yet. So now we go ahead and write 25 gigabytes. So in our 100 gigabyte volume, we've got 25 gigabytes of data written, so 75 gigs are effectively unused. But we have reserved, LUN space reservation has designated an additional 25 gigabytes. Now we're going to go ahead and take a snapshot. And effectively, those first 25 gigabytes are now read-only and not able to service client writes. And so we've got, in order to guarantee that we'll always be able to satisfy those writes, we have reserved some space for overwrite, in the volume. Next, we write an additional 25 gigabytes of data, and an additional 25 gigabytes is reserved for future overwrites. Now we take another snapshot. And as you can see, we have basically 50 gigabytes of data that is in a read-only state and 50 gigabytes that is reserved. And you'll see this if you run the df-r command in data ONTAP, and you'll see exactly how much is being reserved. If we overwrite 25 gigabytes of data, essentially 25 gigabytes of the existing data will become unique to a snapshot. And at that point, we will no longer be able to reserve a full 50 gigabytes of writable space in the volume. So if you attempt to take a snapshot at this point, which would have the effect of locking 75 out of the 100 gigabytes, it simply won't let you do that because of the reservation setting. So your snapshot will fail. And in fact, the error will be something along the lines of no space left on device. Now let's say we go ahead and delete all those snapshots. Well, since none of the blocks in the file system are read-only anymore, you have 50 gigabytes of real data written to the volume and 50 gigabytes free. Since you can go ahead and reserve that 50 gig if you were to take a snapshot, you can at that point go ahead and take your new snapshot. That's why in many cases you have to delete snapshots in order to be able to take new ones. So if you remember in the first step of that illustration, there was space designated in the volume for the LUN, but there was no data written to the LUN. So how do you know at any given time how big the LUN really is? Because it is, in effect, negligible in size when you first create it. Well, starting in data ONTAP 8.0.1, we have the added output of the LUN occupied size in the LUN show-v output. And this is this part of the output doesn't change regardless of your privilege mode, whether you're in advanced diag or standard admin privilege mode. And what you can see in this particular example is the LUN actually occupies 24.5 gigabytes when this command was run in the WAFL file system. But the LUN is designated as being 50 gigs. That's available in ONTAP 8.0.1 and higher. Prior to that, the LUN occupied size variable was never exposed to the command line. There's nothing you can run in data ONTAP to find that out. The only thing you can really do to get the LUN occupied size is if you use the Manage ONTAP SDK. You can use zExplorer from that. Anything that can use Zappy against the filer, because the occupied size is exposed through Zappy prior to ONTAP 8.0.1, and you can run the LUN get occupied size Zappy call against the LUN and get this output. But again, prior to ONTAP 8.0.1, there's no way built into ONTAP to see the occupied size. So let's do some examples without space reservation on the LUN. Now, again, remember in the layers of abstraction, we're all the way up at the top. We're talking about the LUN. We're not talking about the volume at this point. If you remember, one of the purposes of the LUN reservation was to reserve the amount of size of the LUN in the file system at time of creation, or at any time you try and enable that option. With that turned off, you can actually create a LUN that's larger than your volume. So in this example, we've created a 110 gigabyte LUN in a 100 gigabyte volume with no space reservation. We go ahead and write 50 gigabytes and create a snapshot. And remember, this is a SAN host writing 50 gigabytes of data to their file system, which we receive and write out in the LUN file. Write an additional 50 gigabytes and take another snapshot. And remember, the volume is only 100 gigabytes. So now we've got 100 gigabytes of data that is read-only. The LUN is 110. And from a SAN host perspective, it believes all 110 of those blocks are read-write. If you write any additional data to that LUN from the client, the LUN will be taking offline because there are no free read-write blocks in the FlexVol to satisfy those writes. The reason the LUN is taken offline is to prevent it from getting any more corrupted or damaged than it already is, which with most modern file systems, there really should be no damage. Most modern file systems are going to have some recovery mechanisms built into them in case a LUN or disk were to be taken offline at any given time. LUN creation enables space reservation by default. So if you run the LUN setup wizard, or if you run the LUN create command, unless you specify the dash O no reserve in the LUN create command, you will have a fully reserved LUN. If you create a fully reserved LUN or otherwise and wish to change that later on, you can run the LUN set reservation command. Now this particular command is a little bit confusing in that the order of variables is not the standard order of variables in a command that you're used to running. So here it's LUN set reservation, then the LUN path, then the variable value. So a little bit out of order command syntax there, but it is what it is. So keep that in mind. Also, if you attempt to enable a reservation and the LUN is already to the point where the volume cannot satisfy that reservation, it will actually error out and give you a message saying unable to set LUN reservation due to insufficient space, or words to that effect. And how would you do that through the system manager? Pretty easy. When you run the LUN creation wizard, there's a checkbox. Checking and unchecking that checkbox will simply set reservation enabled or disabled. Also, after the fact, you can go back and edit the LUN settings, and the same checkbox is there. Checking or unchecking it has the same effect. Space reservation is either enabled or disabled.